Preparations are underway for the country's 114th Independence Day celebrations tomorrow, Tuesday. The theme this year is Kalayaan, Pananagutan ng Bayan para sa Tuwid na Daan. The day will begin with simultaneous flag-raising and wreath-laying ceremonies across the country. President Aquino will be at the Baraswain Church in Bulacan. Vice President Jeje Marbinay will be at the Rizal Monument in Manila. Flag-raising ceremonies will also be held in Cavite, San Juan, Caloocan, Pampanga, Cebu, and Davao. The day's activities include various exhibits, job fairs, and free medical and dental services. The day will be capped with the Malayang Pilipino concert at the Quirino Grandstand and a fireworks display. There will also be free MRT and LRT rides tomorrow from 7 to 9 in the morning and 5 to 7 in the evening. As we said, the country will celebrate its 114th Independence Day tomorrow. It is also the 25th anniversary of the 1987 Constitution. While it is a day to reflect on the lessons from the past, activities this year also aim to celebrate Pinoy culture. Now, here's a peek at how organizers hope to fan renewed faith in the country's freedoms. Okay, joining us this morning is Wakaed Philippines founder and executive director Gang Badoy Kapati. Good morning, Gang.
Good morning, Ron.
Welcome back.
Actually, I need to say because they didn't run the credits. The animation was done by Arnold Arre, a graphic novel artist.
Right. And performed
the
by?
Music was performed by Radioactive Sago Project.
That was by the Radioactive Sago
yes,
Project.
Yes, and that music
didn't sound like them.
And that yes, of course, they had to divert every now and then. Pero and that video was produced by Rock Ed with the National Historical Council of the Philippines, Commission of
in coordination with
I think
the
it's
NHC.
Commission. National Historical Commission yes. of the Philippines.
How long did it take you to do that?
Actually,
it looked nice, by the way. Very
you.
Nice.
Aganda naman ang pagkasabi mo. It looked nice. Actually, that video, Ron, we really encourage people to download it on the internet. It will be available tomorrow. Mm-hmm. Schools can use it for their flag ceremonies, companies, corporations, or etc. Our only request, actually, no, our only command is that you follow the flag and heraldic law when you do screen this video. Kasi it's not meant for entertainment. It's really for accompaniment in the morning. You know, treat it like a minus one with a video and for schools.
Right, diba? Right, right. Then how do they download the video?
They can download it on a YouTube link tomorrow, which I will post through at Rock Ed Radio. The Twitter account is at Rock Ed Radio. Of course, it will be hopefully spreading through your Facebook accounts and your Twitter accounts otherwise. So if you can see it now, because it's running right now on the screen, this animation is done by Arnold Arre. He's a graphic novel artist, but he's venturing into animation now. This part where the lady is, that's the part where you say, duyan ka ng magiting, and when magiting happens, it's the lady. I actually test ran this video with a few children, actually they're children of somebody from ABS-CBN, and one of them said, ang lungkot naman, because he saw this part, where the Kappa's death march, you can see it right now, and he said, ang lungkot naman kasi it's so sad, but I wanted to emphasize that hero, the rice grew from someone's sacrifice, so it's highly symbolic, it's rather simple and rather obvious actually, but sometimes we forget.
But Gang, why?
And we end with this, Ron, like it's a baby. You have a new baby.
Yes.
Yeah. Ang mamatay nang dahil sa'yo.
But why come out with an animated video to accompany the national anthem?
Well, you know, I think we've seen all our, you know, no offense intended, actually. We're kind of used to videos of our national anthem that have politicians in there, but there's no problem there. But yes, there is a problem there because sometimes it's dealt with as a campaign material, etc. And sometimes they also show inaccurate stuff in on our history and etc. So this one, because we consulted with the National Historical Commission, we really worked on it. I think it's about time we have other visuals we feed ourselves on the Philippines. And I think animation can make it as adventurous as it can be. Hindi siya kasing limitado ng real shoot. For example, like this one, it started with the stars and then it went down the stratosphere and then down to the our ancestors and then down to the Kapas March and etc. etc. I think because we always have photos that are negative, especially on the internet about us. The only thing I can think of right now is during the Hong Kong bus hostage crisis, there were photos that went around of Filipinos posing near the bus, which is really tragic. So sabi ko, maybe we should battle these negative images by sending out as much positive images as possible. And I think animation offers you that, a whole wide array of showing you what our culture is, how our history started. And I think it's about time we had an animated video.
Even if you think that animation is more geared towards kids, they'll be able to understand. I mean, a lot of people.
Taon ka na nanonood ka pa siguro ng
nanonood pa akong cartoon.
At siguro meron din may rawness din yung drawing eh.
Right, hindi naman siya pambata din yung dating eh. The way it was drawn, the animations and the scenes that were shown in the video, not necessarily pambata, but it does give you for adults, it does give you like the death march. Scenes of our history.
We really tried to stay as positive as possible, but I think it was necessary to show the death march, etc. Even Arnold Arre is such a genius. He really wanted to show he really wanted to illustrate that from other people's sacrifices, things grew.
You have to show the struggle.
And you know, I think Araw ng Kalayaan is really about that. Marami nagsasabi kasi, why are we spending for Araw ng Kalayaan where we could do it, we could spend the money on other projects, etc. Or FIDIC. For education, and I believe that that's a valid point. But I think every now and then we should really pause, or I think every June 12, we should just pause and really thank people who gave us our freedom.
Tatanong ko eh, kulang ba yung pag-celebrate natin ng Independence Day?
Wala. Hindi ko alam kasi kung ano yung sapat na sapat, but all I know is, kailangan naman natin mag-pause, stop tayo and say thank you and celebrate what the Filipinos of the older generations gave for us to be this free. I know this year that they got rid of the usual float parade in San Rojas Boulevard, and that's good. That's a way of cutting down. And I must admit, since we're working on this concert, the budget was really a lot smaller than we imagined. But our volunteers, the musicians, are playing for a lower, volunteer rates almost, and etc. And I seriously think that it's a worthy thing to take time out to really make the country pause when it's June 12.
Right.
Parang birthday mo, ayaw mo naman na dumaan lang tas wala, di ba?
Oo nga eh, kasi ano nangyayari? Pagdating ng June 12, parang holiday lang sa ibang, lalo na sa mga bata ko minsan. Wala lang pasok sa June 12. But other than that, you know, you can't think, nung mas bata ako, iniisip ko bang i-celebrate ang June 12? Wala, holiday lang. Bahay lang ako.
Parang hindi natin masyadong naiisip.
But for now, you're giving kids and everyone a reason to celebrate. And think about what the others have done for our independence.
Or just, it's really just an elaborate pause. And para na siyang magarang thank you sa mga nauna sa ating Filipino. Kasi, you know, seriously, ang sobrang laya natin eh. And sometimes we forget na other Filipinos of the older generations made sacrifices para maging ganito tayo ka-free. Hindi lang from the Marcos Martial Law era, hindi lang from way, way back. Yung mga people of the older Filipinos of the older generation thought of us, di ba? Nung nagsasacrifice sila, nung nag-aaral sila, nung nagtitipon sila sa katipunan, all those things. And we really should be grateful for that. And just like any special day or just like any birthday, it's tama lang na mag-pause, di ba? I think. So June 12 is this. It's a great pausing and thanking people, Filipinos.
But talk to us about the events that are going to happen
tomorrow. Tomorrow, actually. The Quirino Grandstand is now being prepared. Tomorrow, there will be several things like you mentioned at the intro. There will be job fairs in the morning sa Luneta. And I heard that there's thousands and thousands of job positions offered during this job fair as prepared by the DOLE. And then there is a Discuento caravan where the DTI will be going around with school supplies, rice, etc. And all at a discounted price. Mm-hmm. Oh, ang galing ha eh. And then, of course, there will be other activities. In fact, in Luneta, there's a Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao program. For Luzon, there's the Noel Cabangon. He's from Ilocos, etc. The Visayas program is really interesting. It's actually Pilita Corrales, Pinky Marquez, and all the other Visayan artists also. Elizabeth Ramsey, I think, also. Mm-hmm. And then Mindanao will have the cultural dances and etc. I'm not sure. But then for the evening, there's a lot of artists. Actually, sila Wally Gonzalez will be there. The older artist, Bong Soto, Gary Perez, etc. But in the evening, where latter part, syempre pang young na to, this is where the rock ed part comes in. Oh. Wow, our artists are magnificent. In fact, this is a great lineup. Radioactive Sago Project, Kamikaze, Sandwich, Pedicab, Glock 9, The Dawn, Rico Blanco, Flippin' Soul Stompers, Paolo Santos, and I think I forgot someone, but then hopefully I didn't forget anyone. Parang hindi naman.
Parang ang dami nun.
Ang dami, Kamikaze. Nakakaalim
na eh. And speaking of sacrifices, they volunteered for this one, right?
Yes, actually, hindi talaga to commercial arrangement. In fact, I'd like to, like, if I could make a special mention to Kamikaze, because they just lost their manager,
Richard Tan.
And I tried to offer na, parang baka you don't, baka okay lang na hindi kayo tumugtog, kasi I know you're grieving. But, you know, ano sila, parang they know that it meant something or it means something, and that perhaps their late manager will appreciate also if they participate in Junjo. So I think this is the kind of sacrifices individual Filipinos give to just say, yay, Philippines tayo, diba? Mm-hmm. Kahit every now and then. Because, you know, there are many things we're not very proud of about the Philippines, but there are also very many things we are proud of, and one of which is, of course, our music, diba? Kahit anong bansa ka pumunta, measure for measure, ang galing ng Filipino artist. And so I thought this was a good chance to start on that proud note again. No, parang ganun.
Okay,
kasi Pacquiao natalo kahapon. Affected ako, diba? Grabe.
Okay, we're giving you the chance to invite everyone again.
Okay, tomorrow. Oh, should I look at the camera? I'm not a pro.
Anyway, which one? Okay,
which
this one.
Here? Okay. Oh, there.
There, okay. You go.
Tomorrow at sa Quirino Grandstand, kung may oras kayo, actually, kahit wala kayong oras, please drop by because it's Araw ng Kalayana celebration. We have lots of artists tomorrow. I even have a código. May I say all the artists performing because I really need to thank them. Pete Canzon, Jess Bartolome, Gary Perez, Bong Soto, Wally Gonzalez, the AFP Band. Can you believe? I wonder how they sound. Manila Police District Band, Flippin' Soul Stompers, Paolo Santos, Sandwich, Itchy Worms, Pedicab, Radioactive Sago Project, Rico Blanco, The Dawn, Pupil, Glock 9, Kamikaze, and before I end, you have to still have me on air, right? Oh, sorry. You have to have me on air, right? Ballet Philippines is actually participating. They will be dancing with two bands, Pedicab and Radioactive Sago Project.
Ballet Philippines
and
dancing to
a rock band. And that's very new and that's very different. And you have never seen anything like that. So Ballet Philippines agreed to dance with a song by Pedicab. You've heard them. They're very funky. And Radioactive Sago Project. So that's something to see, I think. And also tomorrow, we would like to show on large screen the video you just aired here.
Okay. Gang Badoy of Rocket Philippines.
Morning,
thank you
ANC.
Very much.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. From tennis to Formula One to basketball to horse racing, Paolo lets us catch up with one of the busiest sports weekend yet. And today, we'll also ask you, how do you come to terms with unexpected defeat? Join our discussion when we return. This is Mornings.